Friends, the Punjab and Haryana High Court, Justice Sudhir Mittal has given a judgment on the segregation of students in the schools, particularly in the private schools. So normally, the court held that if the school puts top scorers in one section and segregates the others in another section, it is a violation of fundamental rights and also human rights. So what happened is Dr. Neetu Kukkar, a woman doctor, she filed a petition before the High Court of Punjab and Haryana with allegations that the local school in which her daughter was admitted and who is now studying 8th class. Since 6th class itself, the cream peoples, that means the persons who got more than 90%, they are segregated into one section while the others are segregated into another section right from her 6th class itself. When this doctor put a question to the management, they said it is an old custom, it is an old convention for them. But she did not agree, and she leveled allegations against them, but they did not hear. Ultimately, she approached the High Court, and as per her contention, the school people were being separated from 6th class to 10th class according to the CBSE syllabus. Those who get higher marks, they are being given into A section, while the others are divided into B, C, D and things like that. And there is an inferiority complex among the students, that the others, the who are in the A section, they are intelligent people, they are being elevated to higher positions, all these things, they are being treated, and that means there is a disparity among them, a feeling of inferiority among them. This is what the court noticed. Now, the court, as usual, gave notices to the school, and they tried to defend themselves by saying that it is an age-old custom, but the court did not agree. Here, Justice Sudhir Mittal, he said, Article 21A is a constitutional right. It makes education as a fundamental right, particularly after the age of 14. That means elementary education is made compulsory. So, the intention is that the children should get a conducive atmosphere for the all-round development, not only in education. He should dedicate certain time for the sports. He should have some extra curricular activities. In all these things, the child should be exposed, not only in the education. So education means not only getting up marks, not only mugging up things, but education means it leads to wisdom. Therefore, the student should be exposed to all the types of education, and he should mix with the other students also. But what is happening is, when the cream is being separated and there is inner feeling among the other students that they are not subjected to equal treatment, and this is getting a negative impact from them, and this is giving them the so-called inferiority complex. Therefore, the court held that it is a violation of the fundamental rights, and it also violated the equality among the opportunity section. So equality of law and equal opportunity, like that, is also violation of that same, the High Court has added. So therefore, the court held that under the constitutional scheme, no doubt, everybody should get the so-called education, free and compulsory education for that part. So therefore, the institutions are bound to create a free and open atmosphere, but not a negative atmosphere, where actually the schools are supposed to have the so-called sense of equality. They promote the sense of equality. That's why the system of discipline or the evening are imitated only for that purpose. Otherwise, the higher people, the breaker people, they come in cars, they come in branded shirts, whereas the other people, they may not be able to bear things, and therefore the feeling of inferiority comes with them. To avoid all these things only, the so-called systems have been made, right? They called the school. They stated that it is an old norm, and the petition is a motivated one, and the people who are not happy with the system of discipline and other things in the school, they wanted to cast aspersions, or they want to level allegations against the institution. And when their children could not be admitted to this particular section, she got annoyed and she filed this false allegation. So, but here remember, the court did not agree, because there was another incident that is also coupled or tugged into the same incident. What happened is, there a girl studying 6th class, since she is not mixed with the cream, she got annoyed and she attempted to commit suicide, and her parent, her father, brought it to the notice of the school, but to no avail. They did not take any action. Therefore, he filed a petition to the court as well as to the Child Rights Protection Committee and also to the Central Board of Secondary Education. All these things he has made. Luckily, the Protection of Child Rights Committee, they visited the school and they advised, or they have ordered, directed that the school should dispense with the system of the separation of the bright students with the inferior students, and it should be stopped. They have given a direction that from the month of August, the system should be swapped and the students should be mixed. They should be mixed, and all these things they have given directions. But they went to the higher authorities, the school management went to the higher authorities and got the orders stayed up to this academic session. So from next year onwards, there is no separate A and B sections, all of them should be clubbed. So now the court has stated that the Protection of Child Rights Committee, they do not have that much of review power. And once they give a direction, it should be implemented. And if at all there is any deficiency or any aggrieved party, then they should come to the court and not to the commission for review. Anyway, what happened is happened. But from this time onwards, once the exams are over, this practice of segregating the students, or separating the students, separating the top scorers from the mark, those who got less marks, it should be avoided. The court rejected. Right. Now, same thing is happening in entire country. You may be seeing in the good academics and education centers like Narayanacharya, the Chaitanya, all these people, they follow the same procedure. They take the cream. Of course, when we interacted with them, they say that it is necessary for them to get ranks. For the ranks purpose only. You may be saying, once the results are announced, they will say, luckily, the AP government has put a ban on the so-called ranks. Only they are telling about the scorer like that. Now, still, they are continuing the age-old practice of the so-called cream. But anyway, definitely it creates an inferiority complex among the students, and there is no equality of rights. 100% the court is correct. But see the other side of the coin. The parents whose children are excelling in their education, who are getting 90-95%, definitely they insist that their children should get more emphasis, and their children should be guided more practically, more effectively, more efficiently, so that they get ranks. Of course, you are joining your children in the education institutions, particularly in the so-called private institutions, only for getting the ranks. So for that purpose only, nowadays every parent is thinking that his son should become a doctor, his daughter should become anything like that only they are telling. So they are forcing pressure on the students also. Definitely there is so much of stress and strain on the parts of the students also. Anyway, so this is the other side of the coin. To satisfy those type of parents, these people, the institutions, of course, their personal thinking also there, they want to get notified whenever the students get good rank, then only they will get notified. So next year, so many people will join. Anyway, in the comment section, some people are saying that a Supreme Court is unnecessarily interfering in such a baseless issue. Of course, it is for the college. So if they are more interested, the Supreme Court already is overburdened with the so-called public interest litigations. Everybody is taking like that. Even the high courts are also overburdened. If at all they have got that much of interest, let them fix the fee structure to the private schools. Let them control the schools. Of course, it is the job of the administration, not the court. Anyway, there are diverging opinions, and some people say it is a very good judgment, and some people say Supreme Court is unnecessarily, so High Court is unnecessarily interfering. Whatever it is, but we have to agree that the so-called separation of the students into cream and non-cream definitely not allowed and is violative of the fundamental rights. So please look into the judgment and better gear up with your area education institutions. If any such thing is found, you can also file a public interest litigation, and definitely you will get a positive reply. Thank you.